So in this presentation, I'll briefly describe the relevant anatomy, present our form cases, and describe our structure technique. The vessels go transversely. So if we go longitudinally, it would be very hard to cannulate them. And of course, longitudinal injections would be safer than transverse injections. Go along the vermilion border, and I try to fish for the tunnel beneath the border and see the filler running through it. You might be able to see in the next few injections the filler. If you're in the tunnel, it will just flow in front of you, ahead of the needle, and it will. This would be totally safe. However, if you want to add more volume, then you will have to inject longitudinally, starting from the skin and ending down there to give more volume. This injection, the filler reached up to this corner. This is another technique without a lip block. My colleague, Dr. Heba Darwish, who's sitting here, she's injecting a filler with a local anesthetic very slowly. So the patient is tolerating it quite well. So both techniques are okay. She's along the vermilion border. And here, the other approach, Dr. Heba is injecting longitudinally the lower lip to avoid cannulating the artery. She's going perpendicular to it. But I'm still used to how I inject the lower lip. I'm going closer to the border as the artery is closer to the wet-dry junction between the mucous membrane and the muscle. I don't block the lower lip because all we need are two injections on either side, this way and an injection in the middle, usually. So that's it, of course. I'm always looking for any signs of color change or excessive pain during this technique. These are the before and after pictures showing that this technique still fills the lip nicely. If the patient desires a full symmetrical lip, we can do that. And if she wants a more defined or central filling, that's also possible. So these are just different cases. So we didn't experience any vascular adverse events so far over 3 years with any of our doctors injecting, and only mild to minimal bruising because we're avoiding the pathway of the main blood vessels.
1 minute.
So we conclude that the current structured approach appears to be so far effective and safe in avoiding vascular complications in the lips, and thank you.